Hey guys, this is Gitika Rawat. Welcome back to my channel. If you know me, thank you so much for supporting me. If you are here for the very first time, thank you so much for joining me. Today I'm gonna review and give a demo about few of the purchases which I made on Amazon. Really cute, quirky stuff. So first of all, I'm gonna show you the products that I bought. These are the makeup sponges. So I am gonna mention the details of the seller and the price down there below. So these are the makeup sponges. They were a set of three. Second, I bought a teaser brush. Third are these silicone pads, silicone exfoliator pads. They are in the set of two. The last and the fourth one is this highlighter brush. It's a fan shaped brush. So next I'm going to review all the products one by one, starting with the makeup sponges. So as you can see, as I told you that I brought them in the set of three, and I really like how they have given different shapes to all the three of them. Like as you can see, this black one. So this black one has a drop shape cut, so I think this is really good for applying a foundation right there down your eyes. So basically I think the reason they have these cut and the shapes is to provide proper precision to your makeup. The similar way, there is this orange one that I've already used, so you can see the foundation right there. It helped me last time I tried to use it on my nose, so it really helped me to make a slender look to my nose. And then there is this third one. So even with this, I can use it under my eyes or my lips region. So that ways, I think these cuts are really important, because earlier I used to have a basic sponge. So while applying makeup under my eyes and to give my nose a slender look, that got a little difficult with the normal sponge. So I think that ways these sponges are really good, and the quality till now is up to the mark. Like these two sponges are a bit tight and thicker, and this third one is really soft. So whenever you get the sponges, make sure, like once you have used them for a couple of times, like 2-3 times, make sure that you wash your sponges, because that ways you avoid that dirt which is there on the sponge or the previous use material to be not giving any adverse effect to your skin. So make sure whenever you use sponges, try to wash them in after every 1 week or after 2 or 3 times of use. So this teaser brush, I was recommended this by a really dear friend. She is a makeup artist, Madhvi, and she was using this teaser brush for my baby hairs which I had on the front. Like right now my hairs are all open, but in case if I want to go for a very sleeky and slender look, if I want to push my hairs back, that way it really helps manage my baby hairs. And I can always apply a spray to it, a hairspray. Right now I don't have a hairspray. Also, this teaser brush is really good for back combing, so I'm gonna show you how a little bit of how I used to back comb with this. So that's it. That is how I regain the volume. Like I have really thin hair, so just to provide some volume back there, I can always back comb it, brush it through my hair strands, and I receive a pretty good volume in my hairs. So this teaser brush, as you can see, this is how it is. It has a little bit of blunt tip. So if I want, I can use it to provide some parting to my hairs. Like this way I can do it. Like it is not that efficient because it's not that pointed, but otherwise for basic use I can always try it. For my thin hairs, they are fine. These bristles are somewhat in the medium quality, and it's a plastic kind of a brush, and the quality is pretty good. Like it's not very weak in quality. I think it's perfect for the price which is mentioned there. Third, I'm going to talk talk about the exfoliator pads, the silicone exfoliator pads. So these come in the set of two. If you want, there are other sellers also in Amazon that are providing it in just a single piece, but I think two are better than one, because according to the prices I saw, comparing the prices, I found this a pretty good deal. So I can always give this other brush to someone else, to my sister or maybe to my friend or whatever. I can always gift it. So right now I'll just show you how the quality of the silicone brushes. This is how it looks. So this is the back side to hold the brush, and this is the front side. As you can see, if the bristles are really soft, they are not very pointed, and this back side is provided so I can easily have a grip over it like this. And all I have to do is apply some product, like maybe my face wash or an oil. If I'm using a baby oil or olive oil, I can always apply it on the pad, and I just have to use it in circular motions. These spikes on this exfoliator pad are really helpful for removing all the dust and dirt, and also for people who have blackheads or whiteheads. Like if I have some whitehead problem near my nose, so I can always use it in circular motion with my product, and that way it provides a really deep cleansing. So I'm gonna show you the demo next. Now I'm gonna give you the demo of the silicone exfoliator brush. So I'm using my basic everyday face cleanser, and this is foam based, so I'm gonna just put it on the silicone. I'm using a very lesser quantity because I'm just gonna show you the half of my face. So this is how I'm gonna do it. All you have to do is try to apply it in circular motions. I think these are pretty good for the T-zones and for the nose area, because that is the region I have noticed a lot of people, and even me, I have this whitehead problem the same way people have blackheads, a lot more on their nose. So I think it is really good to get rid of those blackheads. In case you want better results, I would recommend, and if your skin allows, using that much coarse particles, then you can always use a scrub, a very light, I think I'll prefer a very mild scrub. You can normally apply it, or maybe directly apply that scrub on this, and you can just scrub the area that requires more exfoliation. Don't try to overdo it, don't try to keep on scrubbing it, don't do it for a very long duration, because that way you're gonna end up doing real harm to your skin. So all that I can recommend you while using this exfoliator. However, this exfoliator is really soft, it is not very pointed, so that way I'm sure I'm not gonna hurt my skin. You can see the dirt that has come out through my face onto this exfoliator. The product price and link is mentioned down in the details, and also I have mentioned the price right there or somewhere on the screen, so you can always see it. And I think for the price I got them for, they are a pretty good and a nice quality brush. I don't think I'm gonna lose them for the next 1 year. So they are very flexible, and make sure whenever you are using the silicone brush, you always try to wash them with vinegar. So that is the easiest way to let go of the impurities from these brushes. So because if the brushes are clean, then only you can use them on your face. If they are dirty, you are gonna end up into a disaster. So try to make sure that you always, either you can use some soap on it or shampoo on it, and you can always rinse it after every use. The last product which I got from Amazon was this highlighter brush. So I really needed a highlighter brush because I have a set of makeup brushes that I got from Miniso, and it had this one brush missing. I really wanted this fan shape brush, because otherwise I used to apply it through my fingers or my other bigger brushes. So that way it used to be over the top at times, and at times it used to be not at the right position. So I think with the precision of this brush, as you can appreciate, The fan shape brush has the bristles which are really, really soft. I tried it and it gives a really nice, like if I have to do it over here, I'm gonna show you the demo, but I think that the bristles could have been bit more in volume, but otherwise I think for the price they are providing it, it's a pretty good deal. And this company is also, I saw the reviews on Amazon, lot of reviews, and I compared the quality of the brushes and the reviews which were given about each and every brush. I think this company gives better results. Apart from this, if you want to go on a higher side, I I have been using Vega brushes, I have been using faces brushes, so they are really good. So I'm just gonna show you the demo of how I use a highlighter through it. So this is the highlighter which I'm gonna use. This is how I'm gonna just brush it off. You have to like really brush a good amount. See? That's like really sleeky and right at the perfect points where I want it. And if I want to highlight my nose, see, I think it's pretty good. So it does not fail for the price they have provided it. That's it. Thank you so much for watching my video. This is Gitika Rawat. Please, please, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you like it, please hit the like button, and your comments and suggestions are always welcome. Have a nice day. Bye bye.